to my heartbeat.
Hello guys and welcome. Today I am doing a video on finally getting the 1 billion gold grab achievement and also doing some clan war attacks. So usually I don't boost, but because I wanted the achievement so bad and so fast, I boosted. Plus I have a bunch of gems, saved up, of course, because I didn't really have any use for them. So I'm just going to find a raid and see if anyone could give me at least 75,000 or more that is exposed. Not many bases giving what I want, but this one might. I think I'll go for this one. Okay. So basically, I like to use my thumbs and just spread all the barge around. Let me turn the volume down, it's too loud. And then, I just like spamming all of my troops, especially on Townhall 8s, because they really don't have much of a chance, especially if they're preemies like this. And yeah, I think they should be able to go in the middle. I'm going to use my clan castle there. Oh wow, it's a witch. Oh yeah, and a lot of you guys have been asking me about Norwegian and Norse server. I just like being on Norse and Norwegian because, I don't know, I think it's more fun than English server in my opinion. And I just like it better. I'm not Norwegian or anything, I'm actually Asian. But yeah. So over here, they go perfectly into the middle, and hopefully they could take out the Dark Elixir a little to pay up for all of my minions I spent. Nope, my wizards got blown up over there. That one just died. There's my witch, and she died. So, I managed to get that much. And guys, I am finally a billionaire! Aw, yee, boy. And tell my clan. Oh, oops. Yeah, that description was for one of my clan mates that wanted to give a witch. So hopefully they don't. Oh, okay. They understand. So now I will show you guys some clan war attacks. Here's one that is super good. Proto, he's a Townhall 9 attacking a Townhall 10 here. And just look at this base. A Townhall 9 is going for this guy. And the thing is, somebody before him attacked, so of course he knows where all the traps are. Unfortunately, that person did not do as well, but Proto is here to save the day because he is one of the best go wipers I've ever seen. And he's going for like the number 4 guy, and he's like number, I believe he's number, he's all the way down there. All the way down there. So here he leers all the, he leers and takes out all of the skeletons, and over here he kills off the enemy clan castle. And he goes straight for the middle, so as you can see here, he attacks on this side and plays down a golem and some wall breakers. So he's breaking into this compartment first. And he goes over here and breaks into this compartment here. So then all the defenses over this side and this side will be able to take it off of the heroes that are soon to be going in the middle. So just a really great attack right here, getting all the percentages in. Puts a rage, a heal, and the heal does a lot because it's out of the Inferno range, so it managed to heal up all his troops so that the wizards and all the other troops could go in the core. And finally his P.E.K.K.A.s, where you cannot even see, take out the town hall. And then that basically wraps up the raid. Easy 2-star for him as a Townhall 9 versus Townhall 10. This is just an amazing attack by Proto. So there you go, that's 2 stars. And this war is a little bit close, but not close enough, because we are doing a lot better than they are at this moment. So if you could see our attacks and their attacks, we managed to have a better score than them. So let me show you my attack. Here's the base I did it on. So over here, I placed down one giant to layer out the enemy clan castle. And of course, it has a bunch of wizards and archers. Then I layered them to this corner because my intention was to break into this compartment, jump in. This king will layer all, will do the magnet, and then it will take all the P.E.K.K.A.s in there and into the core and destruction. So over here, I didn't do too well with the clan castle layer. The wizards kill all of my witches and I'm so sad, but it won't matter. Because I'll just attack over here. Oh, actually, I don't attack it down there. Attack over here. Sorry about that. So anyways, I placed down my P.E.K.K.A.s and my king and a clan castle P.E.K.K.A. and jumped them into the core. And I'm just waiting on this king right here to drag all of my P.E.K.K.A.s in. But as you can see, he doesn't do a very good job of alerting all my troops. Only a few P.E.K.K.A.s go that way, and then they split up. But it won't matter too much. This P.E.K.K.A. takes down the queen in one hit, which is awesome. And as you can see here, my king and all of my troops are doing something in the middle. Activate his ability and finally clean up more percentage. And if you can see down at the bottom, my army is basically the army that will clean up for the 2-star. So of course, I saved a bunch of troops, archers to take out these, and a lot about 5 minions to take out the bottom, because there are no ranged defenses that could take out the minions. So basically, it's a bunch of picking off defenses here. And yeah, I managed to save one spell as well as get the secure 2-star. So very nice raid, and it was pretty awesome attacking him. So here's my second attack on Junior Silva, and this guy has been already attacked for 1-star, so I cleaned it up with a 3-star using this army strategy that I actually never tried before. I was kinda confident in using it because I've been looking at so many replays of people using it, and this attack, I had my queen up. So my first attack, my queen was still asleep, so I just let her keep upgrading. And finally, the last half of war, she fully upgraded to level 21 and I used her. So here I leered out the clan castle with witches and wizards. Over here, trying to take out the building so that my king does not get distracted. And finally, I put him down. The whole point was so that he could jump into the core and kill the enemy queen. So then I spread all my hogs out to the left side here in groups of about like 3 to 4. And the thing with my heals is that they're all connected to where the path the hogs will take. For example, the hogs will go here. This should be a double set of giant bombs. They'll heal up, they'll go over here and go to this side. There should be giant bombs right here too. And then finally they go loop around into this heal. I actually put this heal here so that these troops right here could heal up from this splash damage, because there are no troops around there to take it out and they're going to go there soon. So basically it was trying to make a ring effect for the hogs to take everything out. So more clan castle loons come out and the queen fell down right there, so this raid should be going smooth from here on out. My heroes get in the core, they just take out the town hall, and these hogs are decimating this whole base because there are so many left. So that's basically it for this raid. This guy has been 100%ed with the strategy that I actually never tried before, and I feel pretty good about it. Usually I don't go for town hall 9s, but this was an occasion and we needed more stars because of how close our war was. Let me show you another raid, a defense actually, that this guy did on me. the same guy that I 100%ed, he tried doing the same strategy as me. So he starts off from the bottom here, trying to clear off my clan castle. I have a bunch of random troops in there, so it'll take a while for him to clear. And just look at this attack, it is so hilarious. So over here, good thing over here he clears out my clan castle, and good thing that my witch stays in the back. He starts putting in his heroes and his clan castle actually, and his witches. Then he puts down his hero here and a max golem, but I don't know what he was thinking. It wasn't even doing much, and he had a jump spell, and he could have jumped in his golem and his hero so that he could get in and kill my queen. Finally, he puts a jump right there, which is weird because all of his troops already died out. He manages to kill my queen, trip some of my bombs, and then finally he placed down hogs, just like I did, spread them out at different corners, and he basically places down all of his hogs. But the thing that he didn't know about this base is that it's anti-hog, so I don't know. He didn't do a very good job. The thing that I have to give it to him is that at the end of this raid, you could see most of my defenses taken out, and if he had a little bit more troops and less hogs, he could have taken out my whole base. But instead, this happens, and not many troops are left to take out the town hall. Of course it's an easy one star. I intended this base to be an easy one star, but not really 3-starable or 2-starable. This is my third defense, and it basically ended the war. So yeah, that's it for my defense. This guy attacked horribly and did the attack strategy horribly, and it's just so hilarious. So anyway, that's gonna wrap up this video for the clan war recap and also me reaching 1 billion gold grab. Make sure you guys comment, like, and subscribe, and I'll be coming out with more bases and content for you guys. Thank you so much, and see you guys later. We'll be right back.